And we gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. As we gather here this morning as God's family, I invite you to our celebration. It may not be quite the celebration that you had in mind a couple months ago, but we do believe in God's providence that God has brought us to this day for a reason. We may not understand that reason now, but we know that we can come and celebrate even in the midst of everything that's going on. So it's a great day, a rejoicing day for all of us. But it's a time and place that we remind ourselves that we always live in God's presence. And let's take a moment and remind ourselves of His presence in our lives. Jesus, living Word of God, touch our minds and hearts that we may live as you have asked. Lord, have mercy. Christ, powerful Word of God, give us strength and faithfulness that your message may not wither within us. Christ, have mercy. Jesus, humble Word of God, make us receptive to you and to your message of life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And let us pray. O God, who showed the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who for their faith profess are accounted Christians the grace to reject what is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And I invite you to be seated as we listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down and do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks
be to God. Psalm, the seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
You have visited the land and watered it. Greatly have you enriched it. God's water courses are filled. You have prepared the grain.
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
Thus have you prepared the land, drenching its furrows, breaking up its clods, softening it with showers, blessing its yield.
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
You have crowned the year with your bounty, and your paths overflow with rich harvest. The untilled meadows overflow with it, and rejoicing clothes the hills.
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
The fields are garmented with flocks, and the valleys blanketed with grain. They shout and sing for joy.
The seed that falls on good ground will yield a fruitful harvest.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed for us. For creation awaits with eager expectation the revelation of the children of God. For creation was made subject to futility, not of its own accord, but because of the one who subjected it, in hope that creation itself would be set free from slavery to corruption and share in the glorious freedom of the children of God. We know that all creation is groaning in labor pains, even until now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, we also groan within ourselves as we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Hallelujah.
The seed is the word of God. Christ is the sower. All who come to him will have life forever.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. On that day, Jesus went out of the house and sat down by the sea. And such large crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat down. And the whole crowd stood along the shore. And he spoke to them at length in parables, saying, a sower went out to sow. And as he sowed, some seed fell on the path, and birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky ground, where it had little soil. It sprang up at once, because the soil was not deep. And when the sun rose, it was scorched, and it withered for lack of roots. Some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it. But some seed fell on rich soil, and produced fruit, 100, or 60, or 30-fold. Whoever has ears ought to hear. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord.
And I invite you to be seated.
At this time, would those seeking the sacrament of confirmation please stand? Father Chris, I'd like to present to you Lauren Secreto and Ashley Carlson.
Lauren and Ashley, we welcome you today and we congratulate you on being here. And I invite you to be seated because we still have some work to do. There's something you may not know about me, and that is that I'm a big fan of music. Particularly, I like to go to see live music. I can safely say over all these years of my life, I've probably been over to 1,000 concerts. Been to the biggest arenas and to the smallest of bars. I like to find new artists, new musicians, and I'm pretty much open to any type of music. Pretty much anything that I can understand the lyrics is something that I'll explore and open myself to. And so I find it ironic now that we're not able to sing in our churches, not able to publicly sing. But I found myself watching this past week or two a documentary on country music. And it's really an extraordinary piece of work, and I would encourage you to watch it. It's a little long, but it's amazing how much country music has affected hip-hop music, from rock and roll to what we now call pop music. But at one point, Ken Burns, its creator, spoke about the power of music in a way that just might resonate with all of us today. He says, it isn't just the notes, it's the interval in between. That, in part, is what gives power to music. And for most of us, the last few months might be considered to be that interval in between, a time of silence, stillness, waiting for what's going to come next, waiting for our song to play on. But for one reason or another, the pause button has been hit, giving us the opportunity to take stock, a time for us to rethink what we love and how we love, what we miss, and what we want to be different, what we want to change in ourselves, and what we want to change in our world, what really matters, and why do we think so. Life isn't easy these days, for the music of our lives is missing. We've been reminded that we cannot control our lives or our fates, where we go, what we do, how we live. Something we can't even see with our very eyes, a virus can change everything, everywhere. It can make the music seem like it has come to a stop. And a common refrain over the last couple months has been, we're all in this together. And I'd like to add to it that we're not in this alone. We are in this with God. And God is in it with us. And by the confirmation candidates and our first communion candidates, by being here today, you are saying that you have come to the point in your life where you're ready to acknowledge a greater commitment to God. For today, you will publicly state your faith and your desire to continue to grow as a disciple of Jesus Christ. In a moment, you will state that God is an important part of your lives, and that you will rely on and trust in God as you continue your journey through life. And like all of us, you will make some mistakes regarding to the promises that you make before us today. For being loyal to Jesus Christ is not an easy thing to do. You will be tempted to abandon him. You might even become to believe that your worship in him is a waste of your time and energy. And other things will begin to fascinate you and pull you in different directions. You might even compromise for what you know is God's ways to that of your ways of your friends or even strangers. But whatever the future will bring, there's one thing today that you can be absolutely certain of. God's love for you will never stop. God's love for you will never stop, no matter what you choose or say to do. For God will always be there to help you. The God who loves you and journeys with you right here and now will do so forever. For the Holy Spirit is here, just as Jesus promised, inspiring us to do what we cannot do on our own, helping us to take risks that we thought we did not have the courage to take, speaking up even when we're not exactly sure what needs to be said, reaching out to help when it'd be just so much easier to take care of ourselves. The prophet Isaiah tells us this morning that the word of God does not fall to the earth without accomplishing its purpose. That means that the seed of faith, sown in hope, will take root. It may not be apparent to us today. It might yet require long days of work, some sore muscles, and even some dust-filled eyes. Yet for those who place their hope in God, God's word, even planted in the cracked soil of a pandemic, will produce good and bountiful harvest, a result beyond our wildest imaginations. And so we open ourselves to the wonders of what we have been missing. But we rejoice and give thanks for what we have been given. But the Holy Spirit is here and alive and well. The silence might be hard and the interval between the notes might seem to be growing too long. But our song does go on. Our life plays on. Because we know that in such a climate, the word of God does take root and produces a bountiful harvest. Lauren and Ashley, I invite you to stand. Before you receive the Spirit, I ask you now to renew the profession of your faith that was made in baptism, or your parents and godparents made for you in union with the whole church. So I ask you this morning, Lauren and Ashley, do you renounce Satan and all of his works and empty promises?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, the Creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who today through the sacrament of confirmation is given to you in a special way, just as he was given to the apostles on the day of Pentecost?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
Lauren and Ashley, this is our faith. This is the faith of our church, and we are proud to profess it through Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the rest of you, I invite you to pray to God, the Almighty Father, for Lauren and Ashley, for they are already born again to eternal life and baptism. But let us pray that he will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them, to confirm them with his abundant gifts, and through his anointing, conform them ever more fully into Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these servants to new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, freeing them from sin, send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of right judgment and courage, the spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with the spirit of wonder and awe within your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Ashley, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, and peace be with you. Lauren, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit,
and with the Spirit,
and peace be with you. And I invite you all to stand. And trusting in the goodness of our God, we now make known our needs and our desires.
For the church, that we will spread the hope and excitement of the good news with both our words and actions, so others may experience the mercy of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For peace in our world, that God will touch hearts and open minds to new ways to promote the common good and safety of all people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the newly confirmed members of our parish, that God will continue to pour out abundantly the Spirit upon them and empower them to serve others with love and compassion. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who will be receiving their first Holy Communion today, that God will deepen their faith, expand their trust, and make strong their love for others. We pray to the Lord. For an end to the pandemic, that God will free the human family from the coronavirus, guide all who are searching for treatments or a vaccine, and protect all who are vulnerable from the disease. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For an end to discrimination, that God will change the hearts and minds of those who judge people by externals and help everyone to recognize the God-given dignity of each person. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, may your word not return to you without carrying out your will in us, and may our prayers not return to us without having been answered by you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And I invite you to be seated. And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread that we offer, fruit of the earth, the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine that we offer, fruit of the vine, the work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. And I invite you to stand. May bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changes of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set us over the whole world and all of its wonders. For us to rule in your name over all that you have created, forever to praise you in your mighty works through Jesus Christ. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we now acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. I can hear you out there. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Oscar, our bishop, and all the clergy and religious. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all. We pray that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And together now, let us pray for the coming of God's kingdom as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory of your church, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us offer each other a sign of that peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm never going to be used to your name, but only to say the word of my soul. And I invite you to be seated at this time. I know that you've already received instruction earlier, but I'm going to remind you of those instructions and see how well you are listening. Everybody needs to keep their mask on. You will be directed in when to move and how to move. And once you get over to the spot there, you'll need to sanitize your hands. Come up to receive communion. I will call you to come forward to receive communion. You need to stick out your hands as far as possible. I will give you the sacred communion. After you say amen, and you step over here to where I'm standing, you demask, consume your host, put your mask back on, and return back to your seat, following the path back to your seat. If this is not your time for your first communion, you can come forward for a blessing and cross your hands over your chest, and I will offer you a blessing. If you're not comfortable for coming forward for a blessing, you would just remain in your seats at this time. And our first communicants will now be directed to their spots. Just then. body of Christ.
Amen.
And I'm going to invite, starting in the back, to come forward. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. And I invite those who received their first Holy Communion here this morning to stand. And we welcome you to God's table. And I invite you to be seated. Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may always grow. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And take a moment and thank and acknowledge those who brought you to this day, not only moms and dads and family, but Tracy and Noel for their leadership and direction to you. And we thank Laura for making sure everything is in its right place and making sure we all knew what we were doing. So we thank her for that. And Father Gerald has been watching behind us here, and we both thank you for being here today. I know it's probably not exactly the celebration that you had in mind, but do know that it is truly a celebration, and then we can do and make what we can of this for our confirmande to our new Eucharistic receivers, that it's up to you now to manifest that, your belief and trust in God and your words, deeds, and actions. And we hope that you will inspire us during this time, and we look forward to your leadership when you lead us out of this pandemic and help us to define who and what we are by your actions and words. So we congratulate you once again. We do have rules that we're supposed to follow upon exiting. You will exit through the gate behind you there. We do ask that you keep the social distancing as you do so. There are some hymnals there. If you want to take one, two, or all of them, you're welcome to do so. It will help you sing at home, keep the music alive. It will also give you the readings for Sunday if you want to follow along the Sunday readings up until November. We're not allowed to put them back in the church, so it's up to you if you want to take one, two, or three. And we do ask that you go, and Tracy has given you ideas to where you can take your photographs. So you can go and take your photographs there. We are also told you not to linger too long, that you're supposed to disperse and go back to your homes as soon as possible. So I have done my duty, I have informed you, and I do hope and pray that you will have a great day and enjoy this day. And again, we thank you and we congratulate you all. And may the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our celebration here has come to its end. May we go in peace to love and to serve our Lord. Thanks be to God.